Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my dear viewers and my dear students. Today we will start short story number 3, the new constitution. New constitution is a story written by Saadat Zarmantu, a Pakistani writer. So he tells us in this story about the British, you know, cruel way of governing on other countries, poor countries. So they were cruel wherever they go, they treat the peoples in a cruel way. So it's a historical story, and it's a story of new constitution. Saadat Zarmantu in this story tells us that Ustad Mangu, who is a tanga driver, is a hero of the story, and he visits the different cities, different areas of Lahore city. It's a matter of before existing Pakistan, right? So it's a matter of 1935 when the British were ruling on Hindustan. So Ustad Mangu one day listens two of his passengers or fares of the tanga that new constitution is going to be introduced by the British to give independence and freedom to the people of Hindustan. So he was very happy. He went to the adda stand and discussed this story, this news of new constitution with his friends. So friends were also very happy. So the date, the time that was given by the British leaders and rulers, that was 1st April 1935. So Ustad Mangu also tried to be happy with this news. So he shares with maximum his friends. So what happened next? One day Ustad Mangu was in his routine in the market. He was moving, and he saw that the British soldiers were walking on the roads and streets, and that was for the local people was very fearful thing for the people to freely move on in their cities. So Ustad Mangu prepares and buys some decorational things, some decoration pieces, or you may call it decoration for the horse, that he thinks that when on 1st April he will be out in the market, so he will see the changes of the new constitution. So he has so many desires in his mind that what type of things will take place on the 1st April. So just one day is remaining in 1st April. After in the evening, the whole day working, Ustad Mangu goes back to home, and at next day, at 1st April, he gets up early, more early than routine, and take out his tanga on the road and wanna see the changes. But unfortunately, there was no change. And he was very surprised. So he picks up a Gora soldier, and a Gora soldier wants to go to Dancing Girls Bazaar, and he was drunk. So Ustad Mangu was in a very angry mood because there was no change. So he treats Gora as it was in his routine, to with full behaviors, with the full respect to Gora. But Gora was not in a mentally okay. So he also treats Ustad Mangu harshly. They fight with each other, and Ustad Mangu beats him very much, very, very seriously. He beats, because there was blood bleeding in the nose of Gora. People gathered there and they tried to save the Gora from the clutches of Ustad Mangu, because as he was beating him. So Ustad Mangu is in lockup. He's arrested and he's in the lockup, and he's crying over the new constitution, new constitution, new constitutions. We are Hindustani. Now today is 1st April, so it's a new constitution. We are independent, we are free, we Hindustani people are free. But the police inspector replies him, "Oh fool, there is no new law has been introduced. So you are living in a fool's paradise." So, Ustad Mangu is the representative of Hindustani people in 1935 as a Muslim. He was Muslim, but he represents the Hindustani or Indians, where all different nations peoples are living together. So this was absolutely very, you know, cruel behavior example of British rulers. So my dear students, important question, Ustad Mangu's character is very important in this story, that you must prepare it, and for your final exams, that will be enough to handle your final exams from particularly this story. So subscribe my channel, and inshallah, in next lecture, we have our next lesson and the detail of the next lessons. Thank you very much.